فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
أن تضاف that the ذو it has another condition stipulated on it, which is that what it's attributed to is a what? It's an apparent noun. The noun has to be what? The noun has to be apparent. It can't be ذو, it can't be a pronoun. It can't be a ضمائر. You can't bring a كاف ولا كي ولا كما ولا كم ولا كن, none of that. ذو has to have an اسم جنس ظاهر. It's not just an ism, ظاهر. It's an ism, جنس ظاهر. What does ism, جنس ظاهر mean? We'll come to that inshallah ta'ala. But for now, what you just need to realize is that it has to be attributed to ism. It has to be, that thing that is attributed to has to be a jins. Like for example, ذو علم, ذو مال. صح? It's attributed to something. You can't do it to a calf. The second condition is أن تكون بمعنى الصاحب. Are we all together? That it means the meaning that's in it is صاحب. Are we all together? It has to have the meaning of صاحب. If it has another meaning, then no. It has to mean صاحب. Are we all together? The possessor. It has to have that meaning. If it has any other meaning other than the word صاحب, صاحب here doesn't mean companion. It means to possess something, to own something. It has to have that. It has to have that meaning. If you say, for example, جاء ذو قامة. جاء ذو قامة. Can you say that? Yeah? Huh? فعل is what? قامة is what? قامة is a فعل. Can we do that? Yeah, you can. The word ذو here doesn't mean صاحب. It has another meaning. It's taking the اسم of الذي, موصول. So it's جاء الذي قام, the one who stood came. Does that make sense? So it's got nothing to do with us right now. We don't deal with it. Are we all together? It doesn't meet both of the criterias. Does that make sense? It doesn't meet both of the criterias. Now the word ذو here is الذي, the one who stood. Does that make sense? فَإِنَّهُ this حَالَ now the word ذُو is dealt as a مَبْنِي. It's not dealt with as, because it doesn't have the meaning of the word صاحب, possessor. It has a different meaning. We don't take it. And also of course it has to have a اسم جنس ظاهر. It has to have a, we're going to speak about that in more details. Those are the two conditions for the word ذُو. Does that make sense? Before we move on, does everyone understand it? Huh? You understand here now? Okay, one more time. What don't you understand? Yeah, okay. You got given the diagram, right? The picture of the diagram. Yeah, just look at the diagram that I gave as well. It's on there. It's on both of the points that I draw. أن تكون بمعنى صاحب. أن تضاف إلى اسم جنس ظاهر. Okay, now let's go to the فوكه. فوكه. فوكه, it has only one condition. What does فوكه first of all mean? It means your mouth. فوكه means your mouth. The only condition that it has is that أن تخلو من الميمي. That it's, there's no meme in there. أن تخلو من الميمي, that there's no meme in the letter. The word. Because the word Fam is mouth as well. صح? The word fam is also mouth. So it can't have a mean. It can't be fam. Okay? Because they mean the same. It has to be fu. That's the only condition that it stipulates. The word fu is mouth. Fam is also mouth. It can't be fam. Okay? It has to be fu. If it's fam, then أُعْرِبَتْ بِالْحَرَكَاتِ الظَّاهِرَةِ We do إعراب of the حركات which are ظاهرة. So we'll say, هَذَا فَمٌ حَسَنٌ رَأَيْتُ فَمًا حَسَنًا That's how you say, نَظَرْتُ إِلَى فَمٍ حَسَنٌ These are the conditions for the أسماء الخمسة. These are the conditions for the what? These are the conditions for the أسماء الخمسة. Anyone have any question?
Yeah. Everybody else, you use the word
hamuki, mm-hmm.
but abuka,
Beautiful. Beautiful. So the question Dr. Faisal asked is very important, which is ahuka we said, abuka we said, fuka we said. And then when it came to the word hamu, we said hamuki. And we said you can't say hamuka. It has to be hamuki. The reason is because the word hamu is always attributed to the woman. It's never attributed to a man. It's the in-laws, the woman's in-laws. The woman's in-laws. So you say hamuki. It's your brothers, basically, your brothers. Your brothers, when you're attributing them, who do you attribute them to? In-laws, you attribute it to your wife. صح? That's why it's hamuki, never hamuka. That's why the scholars, they say that hamu is akhu zawj. Akhu zawj. It's the brother of the husband. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said in that famous hadith, don't enter upon the women alone and stay with them by themselves in a room. And then the woman said to the Prophet, Ya Rasulallah, أَفَرَأَيْتَ الْحَمُ What about the hamu? And then the Prophet said, الْحَمُ مَوْتٌ He's death. صح? Here, does hamu, does it fall under the conditions that we mentioned? Is it اسماء الخمسة? When the Prophet said, الْحَمُ Why? It doesn't have the إضافة. جميل. It's not mudaf. The Prophet didn't say hamuka. He left it general, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Are we all together? So the hamu is the brother of the husband. This is the one that the brother, the husband kind of trusts his brother, believes in his brother, knows his brother's going to respect him. And that's everything. That's it. And then he comes into the house. He says, oh, yep. Honey, let him in. He wants to go to sleep. He wants to go to the toilet. He goes to the house by himself. No one's there. He's death. It can cause a lot of fitna. Allahu bihi alim. Can cause a lot of fitna. Any other question, brothers? I think asma'ul khamsa need to be well understood. So now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to go over with you guys what we took already, quickly, from the 8. Just quickly go over it. And inshallah ta'ala, we will, because we need to memorize these 8. We need to know it like the back of our hand. We need to know it like that, like the back of our hand, and memorize it.
So you know the first condition that has to be
mufrad? Yeah.
Is it mufrad in terms of
jama'an muthanna, not jumla?
Sorry?
It has to be the mufrad, which is the acts of jama', not the acts of jumla.
So what I mean is the word of the pronoun, is it that has to be singular, the word itself is
singular? The word. No, I didn't say you can't say abukum. I said you can't say abawa kuma.
You can say abukum, abuhunna.
Yeah, you could. I just said you can't say abaukum. Abaukum is jama'a, the word is jama'a. Or you can't say abawa kuma. It's the word that if it's jama. We're talking about the lafz here. We did. The shurud I never mentioned.
Yeah.
I know the shurud, we're going to leave it. We took it, we took where it was. We didn't do mulhaq. Did we do mulhaq? We didn't touch on mulhaq. How do we not? This is not mutamimatul ajrumiyya. This is ajrumiyya. Hey, brothers, sisters, everything. Should we just go over the eight again one more time? So we have a good idea of it. Huh? Okay, what was the first one now? Ism? Ism mufrad, right? What did we say ism mufrad is? Huh? ما ليس مثنن, that which is not a muthanna. It's not tool. It's not a dual. ولا مجموعا, and it is also not. It's not all a plural. ولا ملحقا بهما, and it's not ملحق. We'll take that in somewhere else. Such as the word. So ism mufrad, a singular noun, is basically what is a plural or a jama. When we say jama, we mean it can't be any of the three. It can't be what? Jam'u dhakar salim, jam'u anath salim, jam'u taksir. It can't be any of the three. It can't be any of the three. That's what ism mufrad means. That's what I? Ism mufrad means a singular noun. Good. Then the second one that we took is what? Which one did we take second? Let's go jam'u taksir. Yeah? جمع التكسير. جمع التكسير is ما تغير فيه بناء مفرده. It is whatever the structure of its singular gets changed. The singular has to change. The structure of the singular word has to be broken up. صح? The word was ولد. It became أولاد. We're breaking up the letters. So that's what it is. ما تغير فيه بناء مفرده. It changes. And remember, we spoke about the changing happens in how many ways? Six forms. بالشكل فقط. It changes by the. It changes sometimes by the shakl only. Only the shakl is changed. أسد أسد we say. أسد أسد. What changed from أسد to أسد? The shakl changed. زيادة فقط. Something is added onto the word. Sin wun. It was. Sin wun. What did it turn into? Sin wanun. Sin wanun. Here, what has changed? All that's been added to it is a alif and noon. Number three, bin naqsi faqat. Deficiency or some reduction. Mithla. Tukhamatun. Tukhamatun. We said, if you want to make it plural, what do you say? Tukhamun. Tukhamun is a what? It's basically the burping of the person. Reduction happened. What took place here? It was tukhamatun. The ta marbuta got dropped. So it's a lesser letter. Four, bishakli, waziyada. The haraka changes. And also something is added onto the word. Something is also added onto the word. Rajulun. It was Rajulun. Rajim lam. Rajulun. That's what it was. What happened? Rijalun. He said. Sah. Rijalun. That's how it changes. We have number five. Bishakli wa naqs. The shakl changes and a reduction. Something is taken off. Such as the word ki. Kitabun, 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 kaf ta alif ba, kitabun. What happens if you want to make a plural? Kutubun, 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 kutubun. What happened? You've changed the shakal. Because at first the ka, what did it have on it? It had a kasra on it. What did you place on it? You placed a dhamma on it. Reduction has happened because you've taken the alif out that was in the mufrad. Kitabun. You took it out. What did he turn it into? Kutubun. Good. The sixth and the last one is ash-shakl wa naqs wa ziyada. All three of them happen to it at the same time. And that's like ghulamun. Ghulam is what? It's a slave boy. Ghilmanun. Ghilmanun is what? Is the plural. All three of them has happened. The shakl has changed. Ghu, it was. Ghulam, when it was singular. Now that you've made it into plural, what did you say? Ghil, ghi. You place a kasra on it, so the shakl has changed. Naqs has happened. How does the naqs happen? The word ghulamun, where's the alif that was on the lam? It's gone. That's reduction there. Very good. And the ziyada, where's the additional thing that's been added? The alif on the mim. It's a new alif. That's a ziyada. Where did that come from? Where did the noon also come from? Those are two ziyada. So this is the last one, which is bishakli wa naqsi wa ziyada. That's the six types of taghayyur bina' al-mufrad. Mufradi. The six types of changing that occur on a letter. And it's how many types? Six types. We mentioned them. Then we move to the third one, which is Jam'ul Mu'annathi Salim. We said Jam'ul Mu'annathi Salim is maybe not appropriate to say. We said it's better that we should avoid that. We shouldn't call it Jam'ul Mu'annathi Salim. The reason is because the word hasn't is not safe from any changing. And that's what the word Salim means. What does Salim mean? That it's free from change, it's safe from changing. And the word is not actually safe from changing. It does get changed. What would have been better to call it is مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ وَتَاءٍ مَزِيدَتَيْنِ. It would have been better to call that. مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ. It's anything that it's been made plural by adding onto it a alif and a ta at the end. That is a better way of saying it. Such as نَحْوَ جَاءَ الْفَاطِمَاتُ. Fatimat came. فاطمات هي إزواج جمع عنة سالم مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ضمة ظاهرة على آخره. Good. Very good. The fourth one is الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. What did we say فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء is? We said it is any فعل which it does not connect to it at the ending ألف الاثنين أو واو الجماعة أو ياء المؤنثة المخاطبة. None of those three connect to it. As long as it doesn't become, يفهماني تفهماني يفهمون تفهمون تفهمين, any of those five. Because if alif al-ithnain connects to it, which is the dual alif, connects to the word, or the waw al-jama'a, the waw or plural, enters it, or the ya or feminine enters it, what does it now become? It turns automatically to the opposite, which is amthilatul khamsa. It becomes af'alul khamsa. That's what af'al khamsa is. It's a fi'l mudari' that has been connected to it. What? Alif al-ithnaini, waw al-jama'a, wa ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba. But if it doesn't have it, it becomes al-fi'l mudari' alladhi lam yatasil bi akhirihi shay'. And we also said something else shouldn't connect to it. Nunu al-tawkid and nunu al-niswa shouldn't enter it. But the nunu al-tawkid and the nunu al-niswa, if they enter the fi'l mudari', what did we say? It becomes a Mabli. It is not mu'rab. It leaves the discussion of i'rab. Are you with me, brothers? If nunu tawkid and nunu niswa, they enter the fi'l mudari', it becomes mu'rab, as well becomes mabni. And it's no longer mu'rab. But if alif al-ithnain, or waw al-jama'a, or ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba, connects to the wording, what does it become? It just becomes amthilatul khamsa. Or af'alul khamsa. And it's no longer فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. Then we went on to the جمع ذكر السالم. جمع ذكر السالم, we said هو لفظ دل على أكثر من اثنين. It is any word that shows more than two. بزيادة في آخره. But there's something added onto it at the ending. صالح للتجرد وعطف مثله عليه. But that thing that's been added onto it is waw. Oh yeah, waw and noon and alif and noon, right? Muslimuna, muslimina. So there is a ziyada at the ending of the letter. Good. It does show more than two. It shows three and more. Very good. Salih al-tajarrudi. Salih al-tajarrud means you can break the word muslimuna into its, you can take, muslimuna is how many Muslims? Minimum. What's the bare minimum? Three, right? Three is the minimum plural, right? وَأَقَلُّ الْجَمْعِ ثَلَاثَةٌ. The minimum plural is three. صح. So let's take it. Can we take the Muslims out? So if we say Muslim, 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 and the word can still stand, yeah, we could. Are we all together? It should be a word. When you take the plural back to its original form, it has to be a word. You know why? Because a person's name could be called Muslimuna, مثلاً. You can't say he's جمع ذكر سالم. Are we all together? And هذا ليس صالح للتجرد. It's not صالح للتجرد. You can't do it تجرد to it. But this one, Muslimuna, you can do تجرد. It's Muslim, Muslim, Muslim. Does that make sense? Very good. And also the likes of it can be connected to it. So you can say جاء المسلمون والصالحون.
Okay.
True جمع ذكر سالم can be connected to each other. It's not a problem. These are all conditions that we mentioned. Then we went into today الأسماء الخمسة, which is the last one. We spoke about أبوك وأخوك وحموك وفوك وذو مال. We said there are four conditions which are عامة, they're general, and they encompass all five of them. And we said it is أن تكون مفردة. Second one is مكبرة. So مفردة means it's singular. That it's what? وكانت مثنات أو جمعا. It can't be مثنى and it also can't be جمع. If that happens, أعرب إعراب المثنى. If it becomes a مثنى, it will be dealt like a مثنى. And if it's a جمع, then it's also dealt with the i'rab of the jam' taksir. Are we all together? That's how it's dealt with. The third condition that was mentioned is أن تكون مكبرة. That the word is مكبرة. مكبرة means أن لا يكون مصغرة. It can't be مصغر. If it's a مصغرة, then again أعربت بالحركات الثلاثة الأصلية. Then it's منصوب بالفتحة ومجرور بالكسرة ومرفوع بالضمة. Just take that normal three علامة. That's number three. Yeah. Sorry, number two. Number three is أن تكون مضافة. That the word is attributed to something. It has to be. It has to be أن تكون مضافة. It has to be attributed. It can't be like قوله تعالى إن له أبا. He has a father. No. وله أخ أو أخت. No. You can't say that. وبنات الأخ. Can't say وبنات الأخ. The word أخ is. Are we all together? It's not attributed. So when the brother comes to you from South London, he says to you, Ak. Yeah? And he says to you what? Ak. What's missing from the word Ak? You know what's funny? The word Ak, مثلاً, we can say the makhraj of the khaf is kha is missing. So he's trying to say Akh. No problem. But it's like somebody coming up to you and says to you, brother, yeah. You know, brother. Hi, brother. And what is the fa'idah of it was meant to be my brother. That's the word my brings this good comfort to it. Sah? Sah? It was meant to be akhi, my brother. You're meant to attribute this person to yourself. But you're just coming to a person, you're just saying akh. In Arabic, it doesn't sound very polite when you say to a person akh. It's not even Arabic. You can't just say to a person akh, akh. You can't. It's not right Arabic. Yeah, but everything they like to anglicize it, huh? Okay, أن تكون مضافة. That is what? It's مضاف. And number fourth is أن تكون إضافتها لغير ياء المتكلم. That what if the إضافة is happening to, it has to be what? It can't be a what? A ياء المتكلم. So you can't say جاء أبي, or you can't say that. Or you can't say وقبلت رأس أبي. Can't say that. Kissed the forehead of my father, right? Abi, no. You can't say that. Okay? وَإِنَّ أَبِي كَرِيمٌ. You can't say that. You can if you want to, but I mean, it's not going to be أسماء الخمسة. It's not going to be أسماء الخمسة. Because it's missing one of the conditions. Then we said that there are conditions which are خاصة. As Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid said, مَا يُشْتَرَضُ فِي بَعْضِهَا. It's conditions that are stipulated in some of them now. Condition is placed in some of them. And we said the sub here is only referring to what? Dhu and what? Fuka. Let's take Fuka because it's faster and quicker. Fuka is the last one of the two. is that and takhlu min al-mimi. That meme is absent. The word takhlu means absent. The meme is absent from the word. There's no meme. Good. Then we go to the word dhu. We said dhu and takuna bima'na sahib. It has to be what? Sahib. It has to have that meaning, sahib. It can't be a ism mawsoola. Are we all together? It has to be what? Sahib. Just like Al-Mutanabbi, Abu Tib Al-Mutanabbi, he says in his line poetry, this is not mawsoola, it's ghayr mawsoola. He says, ذُلْ عَقْلِ يَشْفَى فِي النَّعِيمِ بِعَقْلِهِ وَأَخُولْ جَهَالَةِ فِي الشَّقَاوَةِ يَنْعَمُ ذُلْ عَقْلِ يَشْقَى فِي النَّعِيمِ بِعَقْلِهِ وَأَخُولْ جَهَالَةِ فِي الشَّقَاوَةِ يَنْعَمُ ذُو here means صاحب العقل, the one who possesses عقل. That's it. So the word dhu, it has to have bima'na sahib. An takuna bima'na sahib. The second condition, which is what? An takuna, an tudafa ila ism jinsin zahir. That what it's attributed to should be a what? Ism jinsin. What does the ism jinsin mean? Hiya ma dalla ala mahiyatin. It has to show ala mahiyati shay. It has to show the essence of something. Min ghayri nadharin ila afradi. Without having to look at what stems from it and the things that come out from it. No. It shows an essence, ilm and mal and something like that. Okay? Good. And it also has to be dhahir. It can't be a mudmar. You don't want an al-dhamir. If it's a dhamir which is a'id in ism al-jinsi, fa'inu yu'amalu mu'amalatahu. Are we all together on that? We'll stop here inshaAllah ta'ala. And we'll carry on next week, Tuesday, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.